Hi, my name is Alex, and I would like to show you how we made smart bandwidth management in Splynx ISP Framework. The first step, I add a new plan, which I will call Smart 2 Meg, as the title is same as service name and price will be 10. And download speed is 2 Meg and upload is 2 Meg as well. And so then we set up burst limit to 50% of speed. It means that we will speed up the plan up to 3 meg. Threshold is 70% and burst time is 60 seconds. It was basic settings of the plan, and let's go to fair user policy configuration. I don't want to count traffic of my customers between 22 and 6 a.m. So it means the night traffic is not counted, it's for free completely. And then let's go to create some policies. So we have hard limits, which we will not use now in that example, but I will create the rules. The first rule will be night traffic. I want to allow my customers to get more speed during night hours. I'm adding 100% of speed from, let's say, from 10 p.m. till 6 a.m. can be. Yes. And I create the rule which will increase speed 100%. I add another rule, and the second rule will be called limit high downloaders. We have people who download a lot during a day, and let's say that if someone is downloading more than 1 gigabyte per day, we will decrease his speed. It depends on our settings. How we can decrease it 10%, we can decrease it. In this case, let's do it for 50%. And then the third rule, I want to set up fair user policy for all my customers. And the maximum month limit will be, well, for example, 10 gigabyte of upload and download. I can split upload, I can split download, but in this case, I will count all traffic up and down, and what will happen, I will decrease speed to 90% or 99, which is better, so it will almost lock the customers. Let's save. When we save it, we can go to preview and test what will happen. So today is Thursday. What will happen now? So because it's 00, it's midnight, we have a night traffic plan, but without in 8 a.m. we have just no rule. And if we move to 11 o'clock, let's check it again, we have again night traffic, which is plus 100% speed, and speed is 4 meg per second at the moment. What will happen if someone will download, and yeah, accounting traffic is not showing us anything, so we are not accounting this traffic. If we set up that someone downloaded 1.5 gigabyte per day, the new rule is applied for this customer, and customer got 1 meg speed. If someone got more than 100 gigabyte per gigabyte in months, so there is a new limit which is called maximum month limit, and we decrease his speed 99%. This is how it works, and this is how we set up bandwidth management. Let's check what will happen if we will connect as customer, and what will, how we create rules in MikroTik routers or any other routers using radios. First of all, I create a service to my customer, which is called Smart Bandwidth Management. I will choose router where I will place my API rules, because this is MikroTik, and this is PPP username password, and let's assign some IP address for that customer. Let's choose the first available from that network. Add it. Let's go now to networking and check if we can create rules on which router. Okay, let's use rather this router, and on this router we will set up MikroTik. We will set up the name first, so it will be bandwidth management. Save, and now let's change on our customer, the router, where we will create all these rules. Bandwidth management, save. Okay, as I said, this is just an example of how Mikritic, how we create rules on Mikritic on using API, but this can be done also based on radios. Okay, when we connect our customer, this is our IP that we got. Let's try to check if there is customers online. Yes, customer is online, and an online customer, we have all information about this session. So it's 15 seconds active session. Now I want to check if rules are created in Mikritic router. Enable shaper is enabled and API is enabled. Let's go here, and here we see that, as I told, we can create rules based on API and based on radios as well. So in this case we created two rules, which is not needed because we have to choose one type of queuing, because radius is active. Let's go to settings of Splynx and let's disable creation of rules on radius attributes. I'll go to my settings, and here are rate limit attributes which I will just set up the comments. I will copy comment line, paste it there, copy from other side and paste it the other side, and save. When we save, it means that radius will not send rate limit attribute and will not create simple queues on Mikritic. Let's disconnect my customer and connect him again. When I disconnect, and now when I connect back, you can see that there is no radius rule anymore. At the moment I'm managing bandwidth only using Mikritic API. Let's download some file and let's check what speed we get on this queue. The speed is will get up to 3 megs because we have burst availability. As in fact, max limit is 2 meg, but it's bursting up to 3 meg. So up to 3 meg, but after some period of time and calculation based on thresholds and burst time, it will reduce speed back to 2 meg, which is maximum of the plan. So let's wait for a while and see that it will change the speed, maximum speed, to 2 megs. Yeah, now this happened. Next, what we can do is we can simulate what will happen if there is a night tower. What will happen, how this, yeah, there is some kind of statistics. We see that customer already downloaded some files, but I want to simulate the night hour traffic. Yeah, still on 2 meg per second. I'm going to plan, and let's change a bit plan because now it's not night, it's 11:45, so I just will change the night traffic rule to time 11:45 till 12. Okay, I'm choosing 11:45 and to 12. And save. Immediately all rules were applied to Mikritic router. When I go back to my Mikritic router, I will see this change. Yes, there are still 2 meg, but we have to wait for a while and it will change to 4 meg automatically. Okay, now it was changed. And of course burst rates also were changed, so you can see here there is up to 6 meg it can be burst. And this is example of how these rules are automatically changed from the system based on the settings on the plan. How we can verify what rule is active on particular customer? We can go to the system and open his services tab. First of all, yeah, this is my customer, which I will choose, and services. On services, there is the active rule. So on the right side, there is night traffic. When we click on it, we have all statistics about a rule application. can see the speed, action and amount of traffic per day, week and month. Thank you for your time. This is all about bandwidth management.